impotence is not caused by the vaccine, but when a guy is feeling under the weather, such as in that day or two after the vaccine, he might have trouble in bed. This happens if a guy drinks too much, or if he's got a bad cold or flu, or perhaps during that period of flu-like symptoms after the vaccine. And that can be very scary when a guy has trouble down there for the first time, and he might think, oh my gosh, what's wrong with me? And this causes a great deal of anxiety and stress. And then this can lead to what's called performance anxiety, which is really common, not from the vaccine, but from having that bad episode while he was feeling under the weather during the vaccine. And what happens is the next time he goes to have sex, the thought pops into his head, mm-hmm. What if I have trouble like I did that last time? And that causes stress. And our body's way of coping with stress is to release adrenaline. Adrenaline helps us survive real bad physical stress. It draws all the blood out of our fingers and toes and diverts it to our heart, lungs, and brain to survive. It also draws blood out of other less important parts like the penis. And so when a guy is experiencing the stress of what if I can't get an erection, that causes his body to release adrenaline, drawing blood away from his penis and then giving him a weak erection. And it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. And it happens the third time and the fourth time, and it can become a vicious loop. And then the guy looks back and says, geez, this all started after I got the vaccine. The vaccine must have made me impotent. When in fact, the vaccine gave him trouble just in that first day or two, and the rest of it was the performance anxiety. This happens all the time. Unfortunately, performance anxiety is not permanent, can be reversed with behavioral therapy or even a short course of the little blue pill.
What do you mean the penis is an important part? Shame on you, doctor.
He gave all of that good information, the takeaway.
No, I'm kidding. But let's take this opportunity. Let's talk about the phenomenon in general. You know, we need to really clarify, and I think the people that are posting things need to be very careful about what they're saying.
This is what I would say. You know, no matter how big of a celebrity you are or a political figure, whatever your role is in this world of great importance, you're still a human being and you're still subject to fear. And unless you're a medical expert, it's easy to be afraid and to feel the need to avoid something that you're scared of. But the data is really compelling. There's been over 1 billion vaccinations given, and the actual harm and complication rate is really, really low. But we know that the actual harm and complication and even long-term complication rate of getting an infection and getting sick is actually quite high. So if you are concerned about your man's health, whether it's your own junk or your guy's, you want to do everything you can to avoid a serious COVID infection. And the best way to avoid a serious COVID infection is to get a COVID vaccination. After all, it's pretty hard to have great sex when you're dead.
That is very true.
That is good sound medical information.
That is.